interested also in knowing how to change the colors of things on your project so you can make interesting looking maps. Well, you can see what color the countries are right now, this blue. If I double click on that, I do get the symbol selector, where I can go through, and it's got all kinds of different predefined map emblems for areas like that. I can select any of those that I might like. Or I can go over here to the fill color and select any of the different fills that I want, and I can choose the width of the outline and the outline color and change up any of these that I want for the purposes of display. This isn't changing the data again. All it's changing is the representation of this data for this particular project. So now, okay, now they're green. If I were to go over here and add some more data, let's see what else I've got. This world 30 shapefile that I've got right here happens to just drop in some latitude and longitude lines for every 30 degrees, I believe it is. I'm going to add that, and you can see what it looks like here, and it's pink. So, whoa, what in the world happened? Well, I wanted to show this to you in order to demonstrate a couple of things. The first thing is that ArcMap draws what's displayed over here in the display area from the bottom of the table of contents to the top. So countries are still there. Let me show you that I can use this little checkbox right here. If I click this checkbox, I just turned off World 30. I didn't actually get rid of it. I didn't delete it or anything. I just turned it off for visual purposes in this project. So I can turn it back on, or I can turn it off and turn countries off. This is very useful when you're trying to look at data. You don't have to add and remove data all the time. You can just turn them off visually. So what I'd actually like to do is I want to slide World 30 behind or below countries. So all I had to do was grab it and then drag down, and that reorders my table of contents. Maybe what I'd like to do is go ahead and say that this is latitude and longitude. Lat and long back there. I sometimes throw this shapefile onto the countries for a lot of different demonstration purposes, just because then I can go, oh, you know what, I'm going to turn this light color. And that kind of makes it look like an ocean background. Maybe now we're looking at something that looks a bit more like a map, and something that you might have thought what we would be looking at when we're doing geographic information systems. You can remove data if you like. Let's say that I don't want that countries on there anymore. I'm going to right-click it, and I'm going to say remove. This actually removes it from my project. If I want it back, I would have to go back up to add data and add it again. Now see, it did not keep that green color. It came in as a random color again. So I would have to, and it also didn't keep the name that I changed over here. So it came back in as if it were completely fresh, because it is. So I would have to change all that again if I wanted to. I want to show you that it's often possible to label different features that you have in your display area. I'm going to label the countries. I'm going to right-click on countries, and I'm going to go down to label features. And now I get the names of all of the different countries on top of them. Now, obviously, the placement of these labels is terrible. If you're actually going to talk about cartographic production and the making of maps, this obviously won't work. You would have to work a lot more with label placement. But it is possible, in many cases, just to get, for visual purposes, for just general exploratory purposes, it is possible to get labels of different features in the display area. I'm going to turn that off. I would like to point out that this toolbar I'm using up here can be moved around. You can rearrange your toolbars. Sometimes I like to do that. If you need some more space, grab them over here on the edge where you see these little dots, and then drag them to where you want them to be. And you can organize your own ArcMap interface to your own preferences. Also, I want to show you how to turn on and off toolbars. Sometimes people turn off a toolbar accidentally and then they don't know how to get it back, and so I want to make sure that you know how to do that. Do you see all of this gray area that doesn't have a toolbar in it? Well, if you right-click on that, you will see a list of all of the toolbars that ArcMap has. As you can see, there are quite a lot of them. to get to know, and if it has a check by it, then it is enabled. So these two toolbars that I have turned on right now are the standard toolbars, because it has a check by it, and also the tools toolbar. The standard toolbar, if I turn it off, that's the one where we were able to add data. So that's an important one to be able to turn back on. And then also this toolbar, which has all of your selections and your panning and your zooming, that is tools. So you can turn it off and then turn it back on. So if you ever accidentally turn one off, you can always get it back through that method. If you need to turn on a toolbar, in addition to the right-clicking on the gray area, you can also go up to Customize, down to Toolbars, and you will see the exact same list where you can turn on or turn off toolbars. Additionally, sometimes people turn off the table of contents. If you do that, you accidentally hit this Close button right here. Well, now you've got just the display view, and then people need to get it back. Well, you can go to Windows, and then Table of Contents, and you get the table of contents back. I'd like to point out that down here in this corner, as you're running your mouse around, you will see different coordinates change for the area that you are looking at, and then also you'll see what scale you're looking at your map information up here. And we'll talk a lot more about that information in introductory and especially intermediate GIS courses.